In this video, we'll look at how to add our vertical grid as an MVC extension in your web application. The MVC vertical grid is a control that displays tabular data in an inverse manner. In contrast with the regular grid view, the vertical grid displays data records as grid columns, while grid rows represent data fields. I'll start by creating a new empty ASP.NET MVC application using the DevExpress template gallery. To be able to use the vertical grid extension, open the Project Wizard, go to the Suites tab, and enable the vertical grid checkbox. This adds code referencing resources required by the vertical grid extension to the master page view. Now let's add a home controller. And index view. Next, add a data model to bind to the vertical grid extension. Add an ADO.NET entity data model to the models folder. Select generate from database. Create a new connection. Select the required table and click Finish. The model designer opens. You don't need to edit the model, so save it, build the solution, and close the designer. Now you can insert the vertical grid extension to the view. Go to the code and right-click the position where you want to insert the vertical grid extension. In the wizard, click the Data tab and select the vertical grid extension in the list. The main settings allow you to specify the extension name and its partial view name. Here, you can also specify whether or not you want the wizard to generate the controller action handling callbacks related to data editing. In the data binding section, specify the data model class, the entity framework context class, the data fields that you want to display, and the key field name. The additional settings section allows you to specify whether or not to display the pager and scroll bars. You can also enable filtering and column selection. Click Insert and the wizard generates all the necessary code for you. You can see what files have been changed or created here in the output window. Now let's take a look at the result in a browser. The vertical grid is displayed and allows you to navigate between grid pages using the pager. The header filter is also available and allows you to easily filter records by selecting values in the drop-down list. You can also select grid columns using checkboxes in the grid's command row. In the Visual Studio output window, select Output from the DevExpress Extension Integrator. The output indicates that the index view code has been modified by the wizard. The wizard inserted a link to the partial view. The wizard also modified the controller's code. You can double-click an output item and navigate to the change directly. As you can see, actions have been added to the controller's class. Let's take a look at the partial view code and the controller code side by side. The vertical grid's callbacks are handled by a partial action from the home controller. Callbacks related to batch data editing are handled by a separate partial action. This action provides logic for inserting, updating, and deleting records. But keep in mind that the wizard generated all of this code automatically, so you don't need to implement any of the callback handling logic. Let's take a look at the vertical grid setting generated by the wizard. The wizard assigned the grid ID and defined actions to handle grid callbacks. The command row is enabled and displays new, edit, and delete buttons, as well as checkboxes for each grid column. The pager is enabled and allows navigating between grid pages. The header filter button is displayed and default visibility settings are specified for the horizontal and vertical scroll bars. The wizard also defined the name of the key field and rows to display within the grid. And finally, the vertical grid is bound to the data model. The vertical grid can be bound to any IEnumerable or IQueryable object. Now let's modify the partial view code to add some more features to the grid. Let's take a look at the list of the available vertical grid settings. The vertical grid has settings for different aspects of grid functionality, like behavior, cookies, data security, editing, and more. First, let's specify the grid width. You can see that the grid already displays buttons related to data editing within its command row. To get these command items to work, activate the batch editing feature by assigning the settings-editing.mode property. To display a single new command item in the command row header instead of displaying it in each command cell, enable the Show New Button in Header property instead of Show New Button. Next, set the settings-searchpanel.visible property to true to enable searching. Add a category row by calling the rows.addCategory method. Pass a lambda expression that will assign the category row caption and add child rows to the category. Next, add a total summary by calling the totalSummary.add method. Pass the summary type and the name of the data field to be calculated. And finally, enable the settings.showSummaryPanel property to show the summary panel where summaries are displayed. Now let's take a look at this in the browser. The new command item is now displayed in the command row header. Some grid rows are now grouped within a category row, which you can collapse and expand. Here's the summary displaying the total number of records within the grid. And here's the search panel. Enter some text to search throughout the vertical grid records and the grid updates as you type. Now select a grid cell and left-click it to start cell editing in batch edit mode. Modify the content of any cell and click Save Changes. The grid will send a callback to the server to save the updated cell content to the database. And that's it for this video. To learn more about all of our MVC extensions, make sure to check out the documentation on our website. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.